Hi, I'm Eleanor.
I'm Chris, and this is Eiffel Science.
And we're here to tell you all about survivor bias and World War II planes. You've probably encountered survivor bias at some point. Think of the person who tells you,
"My gran smoked like a chimney and she drove the wrong way down the freeway every day of her life and she lived until 103, so it must be fine."
Or something along those lines anyway. These are examples of survivor bias, which goes like this. These activities look less dangerous than they are because you're one of the survivors.
There's a reason why you don't hear many anecdotes like,
"My gran smoked like a chimney and drove the wrong way down the freeway every day of her life, but she died the first time when she was 10.
And that's because they're all too dead to tell them.
During World War II, the Americans wanted to reduce their casualty rates of their air squadrons. Many planes came back riddled with bullet holes in three main areas: the fuselage, the outer wings, and the tail.
They came up with a solution to reinforce the hell out of the areas that had been filled with the enemy fire, which seems logical enough, given that those are the areas that look like they're being hit.
However, the reason why this is such a great example of survivor bias is that the only data they had to go on was from the survivors. Before they could start to reinforce the areas, Abraham Wald, a Hungarian Jewish statistician, took a look at the data and realized the flaw in their reasoning. In essence, the bullet holes in the fuselage, outer wings, and tails on the planes that survived shows this: if planes could be shot full of bullets in those three areas and make it back, that meant that being shot in those areas wasn't very dangerous to the planes.
In fights, if you assume that planes are shot pretty evenly over their bodies, that means that the ones that didn't make it back likely had bullet holes in other areas. His solution was to account for the survivor bias and suggest that they should reinforce all the areas that didn't have bullet holes.
It may seem counterintuitive, but to increase the chances of survival, sometimes you have to listen to those who didn't. Thank you for watching IFL Science. Please subscribe for more content like this.